फिट मार्शी फेसशिप ट्रांसलेटर फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ ऑसिलेशंस, फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ ऑसिलेशंस डेरिवेशन First of all, we need some circuit diagram. Circuit diagram. First step. Circuit diagram. Here, this circuit diagram. FET symbol. In channel JFET. This one is RD. VDD. This one source RS. This one CS. Capacitor C R. Capacitor C R. Capacitor C. This one is R. Connected to ground. This one is output of the feedback network is connected to from this point to this point. This one is V naught. V naught is the output of the amplifier. Amplifier circuit. Amplifier circuit. From this point to this point. This one is a feedback. Network feedback network. This is the actual circuit diagram. Actual circuit diagram of the FET RC phase shift oscillator. Amplifier circuit. Amplifier circuit. This one is the amplifier circuit. Amplifier circuit introduces 180 degrees phase shift. Here section 1, section 2 and section 3. Three identical RC sections introduces each feedback network consists of three identical RC sections. The identical RC section introduces phase shift is 60 degrees plus 60 degrees plus 60 degrees, that is equal to 180 degrees. Total phase shift. Total phase shift is equal to 180 degrees plus 180 degrees, that is equal to 360 degrees. Okay, in the circuit diagram, this amplifier circuit introduces 180 degrees phase shift. This section introduces 60 degrees. This another section introduces 60. This another section introduces 60. Total phase shift is 60 plus 60 plus 60 is equal to 180 degrees. This condition is satisfied, then only this one is first condition. Second condition is loop gain A beta is greater than mod A beta is greater than or equal to 1 for sustained oscillations. These two conditions are satisfied, therefore the FET RC phase shift oscillator generates here output, generates some sine wave. Okay, next, so second one is replace FET, replace FET with equivalent circuit, equivalent AC circuit. Generally, this is the internal JFET. This one is internal JFET. This one is gate, drain, source. Here, input is VI. This one is output. AC equivalent circuit is AC equivalent circuit. AC equivalent circuit is here gate terminal. This one is the source one. This one is drain terminal. In drain terminal, dependent current source is there. The dependent current source is GM. Here the value is VI. GM into VI. This one is the drain terminal and a small RD. This is the drain terminal. This is the equivalent AC equivalent circuit of the JFET. Okay. This circuit is simplified by using the circuit. The above circuit is simplified using AC analysis. That is set VDD is equal to 0 and CS is equal to 0. VDD is equal to 0 and CS is equal to 0. Therefore, this one is the drain resistance RD. VDD is equal to 0 means connected to ground. This one is RS. And the CS is equal to means short circuit across this RS is like that. This one is output. Here C R second section. This is first section, second section, and C R third section like that. The output is connected to input like that. Okay, this one is gate, drain, source. Gate, drain, source. In between source and ground, RS resistance is there, but some short circuit is there for AC analysis. CS is replaced with short circuit. Therefore, RS is also 0. The source is itself is called as ground terminal. For D, consider D a drain terminal. The RD resistance is connected between drain and ground. Drain and ground. Okay. Now this JFET is replaced with equivalent circuit. Equivalent circuit means this one is a gain, source. This one is a drain terminal. Okay. This one is a VI. Dependent current source value is GM into VI and small RD. One more resistance is also there, RD, capital RD. Here the capital RD is connected between drain and ground. Here this one is at the output voltage is V0. Here C, here C, C, R, C, R, and the final one is C, R. This is the equivalent circuit. Here, everybody must know the importance of this below circuit. This one is amplifier gain, amplifier gain A. This one is feedback network. This one is feedback network beta. Feedback network factor is beta. This one is output V naught. Output of the amplifier is connected to input to the feedback network. This one is output of the feedback network is Vf. Input to the amplifier is Vi. It is connected here. Therefore, Vi is equal to Vf. Beta is equal to output voltage, feedback voltage by input voltage is V naught. Gain A is equal to output voltage V naught by input voltage Vi. Here, Vi is equal to Vf. Here, Vi is equal to Vf. The last resistance here is the last one is here is Vf. V naught is the here V naught is the output voltage of the basic amplifier. This one is the this entire one is the amplifier representation. The output voltage is V naught. Output voltage is the input voltage to the feedback network. This is input voltage. Three identical RC section acts as a this one is the feedback network. This one is feedback network. The output voltage of feedback network is Vf. Here output voltage of feedback network is Vf. Input voltage to the basic amplifier is Vi is equal to Vf. Here Vi is equal to Vf. Okay. Now this is the amplifier amplifier representation. Now concentrate on derivation, frequency derivation. Frequency derivation. Consider three RC sections with input voltage V naught, output voltage is Vf. Frequency of oscillations derivation. Frequency of oscillations. Frequency of oscillations derivation. Okay. This one is C R C R C R. Output voltage here is Vf. Input to the feedback network is V naught. Okay. General capacitor reactance is represented by Xc. This capacitor is all these capacitors are three capacitors are replaced with reactance of the capacitance. General Xc is equal to 1 by J omega C. Let 1 by omega C is equal to capital X. Therefore, Xc is equal to X by J. Therefore, Xc is equal to minus Jx. Therefore, these three capacitors are replaced with minus Jx. These three capacitors are replaced with minus Jx. That is minus J capital X here, minus J capital X here, minus J capital X. Three loops are there. This one is loop one, loop two, and loop three. Loop one current is I1, loop two current is I2, and loop 3 current is I3. Consider loop 1. V0 is the output voltage. V0 is equal to sum of the reactants considered in the loop 1 into that current I1 into the two elements which are present in this were R minus Jx. This R is common to first loop and second loop. Therefore, here consider minus I2 into R. This is the first equation. Coming to second equation, there is no voltage source in the second loop. I2 into R plus R 2R sum minus Jx. Here plus minus I1 into R, minus I1 into R. This R is common to first loop and second loop. That is the reason here we use minus I1 into R. This R is common to second loop and third loop, minus I3 into R. This is the second loop equation. Consider third loop. Third loop, there is no voltage source here in this loop. I3 into sum of these three. Sum of these three means R plus R 2R minus Jx. 2R minus Jx. This one is plus. Here this R is common to minus I2 into R. Second loop and the third loop. So three equations. Here beta is equal to, this is the feedback network, beta is equal to Vf by V0. From this one, feedback network beta is equal to Vf by V0. Feedback, find out the feedback factor. Beta is equal to Vf by V0. Here Vf is equal to, Vf is the voltage drop across last R resistance. Okay, Vf is equal to I3 into R. Vf is the current flow through this resistance is I3. Therefore, Vf is equal to I3 into R by V0. According to Carson's rule, I3 is equal to delta 3 by delta. First, find out I3 and then find out beta value. By using above three equations, frame delta is equal to, determine delta is equal to I1 coefficient. First, consider first equation. I1 coefficient is R minus Jx. Second one is minus R. Third one is zero. There is no I3 current. I3 coefficient in first expression. Here, delta is equal to R minus Jx minus R 0 from the first expression. From the second expression, minus R 2R minus Jx minus R. From the third expression, 0 minus R 2R minus Jx. Okay. If consider first row, row 1, row 2, and row 3, some R terms are there. In second row, some R term is there. In third row is also R term. Common the R terms from 3 rows, R into R. Here, 1 minus J X by R minus 1, 0. This is minus 1, 2 minus J X by R, minus 1, 0, minus 1, 2 minus J X by R. Let X by R is equal to alpha. Therefore, finally, R cube into determination of 1 minus J alpha minus 1, 0 minus 1, 2 minus j alpha minus 1, 0, minus 1, 2 minus j alpha. Find out this determined value. Find out this determined value. Here, r cube 1 minus j alpha. Consider this term. Multiply 2 minus j alpha into 2 minus j alpha whole square minus into minus plus and minus 1. 2 minus j alpha whole square minus 1. Consider this term plus 1 minus 1 into 2 minus j alpha minus 1 into minus. Consider this one minus 1 into 2 minus j alpha means j alpha minus 2. 0 into minus 1 is 0. Okay. Simplified this expression R3 1 minus j alpha, expand this one, 4 a square, 4 minus alpha square minus 4 j alpha minus 1 plus j alpha minus 2, that is equal to R3 1 minus j alpha 4 minus 1 3 minus alpha square minus 4 j alpha plus j alpha minus 2 j alpha minus 2. This one is r cube. 1 is multiplied with this one, this entire term. 1 is multiplied with this entire term. 1 into 3 minus alpha square minus 4j alpha minus j alpha is multiplied with 3 minus alpha square minus 4j alpha plus j alpha minus 2. Simplified this one, therefore r cube 3 minus alpha square minus 4j alpha minus 3j alpha minus into minus plus j alpha cube minus into minus plus and j into j square minus 1, therefore here minus 4 alpha square plus j alpha minus 2. 4 minus 4 j alpha and minus 7 j alpha. Okay. Here 3 is there, here 1, 2 is there. The simplified expression is R3. 3 minus 2 is 1 minus 4 alpha square minus alpha square, that is minus 5 alpha square. Here j term is there, alpha cube minus here minus 7 j alpha plus j alpha. Here j alpha cube minus 7 j alpha plus j alpha minus 6 j alpha. Finally, the expression is r cube into 1 minus 5 alpha square, j term is common one, alpha cube minus 6 alpha. This is the delta value. I3 is equal to delta 3 by delta. Now, we will concentrate on delta 3. In delta 3, first I1, I2 coefficients are considered, r minus jx, r minus jx, r minus jx, minus R. Last column is V naught. Here minus R. Zero minus R is zero. That is equal to R. May consider R minus jx, 2R minus jx into 0, 0, 0 into 0, 0. Therefore, this term is 0. Minus R into 0, 0, 0 into 0, 0. Okay. Last one is V naught. V naught into minus A minus into minus plus R into R, R square. This is the delta 3. Therefore, I3 value is equal to, I3 is equal to, we know I3 is equal to delta 3 by delta. Delta 3 is V naught into R square. Delta value is R cube. 1 minus, put a derivation. Completed, the derivation is completed. 1 minus 5 alpha square J into alpha cube minus 6 alpha. Alpha cube minus 6 alpha. Here R is there. Now find out beta value. Beta is equal to Vf by V naught. Vf by V naught. Vf is equal to I3 into R. Already explained. Vf is equal to, here Vf is equal to I3 into R. Vf is equal to I3 by R by V naught. Substitute this I3 value in this expression. Therefore, I3 is equal to V naught by R into 1 minus 5 alpha square plus J into alpha cube minus 6 alpha. This expression is I3 into R by V naught. This V naught get cancelled. R is cancelled. Therefore, final beta expression is 1 by 1 minus 5 alpha square plus J into alpha cube minus 6 alpha. Now, loop gain is equal to A beta. That is equal to A into beta is 1 minus 5 alpha square plus J into alpha cube minus 6 alpha. This is the loop gain. For sustained oscillations, loop gain is for sustained oscillation, total phase shift around the loop is either 0 degrees, either 0 degrees or 360 degrees. Loop means A and beta terms are also considered. Therefore, the J coefficient of the loop gain expression is zero. Then only this condition is satisfied. The J coefficient expression is in this one, alpha cube minus 6 alpha is equal to 0. Therefore, alpha cube is equal to 6 alpha. Alpha square is equal to 6. Alpha is equal to root 6. At the beginning of this one derivation, that alpha is equal to here. This one, alpha is equal to x by r. Alpha is equal to x by r. And x is equal to 1 by omega c. X is equal to 1 by omega c. X is equal to 1 by omega c. Alpha is equal to x by r is equal to root 6. xc is equal to 1 by omega cr root 6. 1 by omega is equal to 2 pi f rc root 6. Therefore, f is equal to 1 by 2 pi rc root 6. This is the frequency of oscillations. Frequency of oscillations of FET RC phase shift oscillator. FET RC phase shift oscillator. Now, for sustained oscillations, for sustained oscillations, A beta is greater than or equal to 1. Therefore, consider A beta is equal to A by 1 minus 5 alpha square. A beta doesn't have any imaginary component. That is the reason J value equal to 0. J coefficient value is equal to 0 already. Okay. Here alpha square is equal to 6. A by 1 minus 5. Alpha square is equal to 6. Since alpha square is equal to 6. Therefore, A beta is equal to A by 1 minus 30 minus A by 29. For sustained oscillations, mod A beta greater than or equal to 1. Mod A beta means minus sign is eliminated. A by 29 greater than or equal to 1. Therefore, the gain of the FET amplifier is greater than or equal to 29, then only oscillations are produced. Sustained oscillations are produced. Next, how to find out the next third step? Find out the gain of the FET amplifier. Gain of the FET amplifier. Consider amplifier equivalent circuit. This one is the gate terminal. This one is source terminal. This one is VI. VI is equal to VF. Here, dependent current source, GM into VI. This is the drain terminal, small RD, and capital RD. This is the output. In the entire equivalent circuit of that amplifier, here consider amplifier circuit only. For feedback network, already beta value is determined. Beta parameter is completed. Next, I will concentrate on gain. This is the source terminal is ground terminal. This is the source terminal. How to find out gain? This is the amplifier gain. This one is VI. This one is V0. Therefore, A is equal to V0 by VI. A is equal to V0 by VI. Here, this is the current source, GM into VI. This is the RD and small RD, capital RD. Here, single node D is there, the node voltage is V0. Apply node voltage analysis at a point D. At a point D, drain terminal. That is, drain terminal voltage is V naught. What are the resistance are connected here? RD, 1 by RD, and small RD, 1 by capital RD. V naught by RD and V naught by capital RD. The current is away from the node, that is minus GM into VI. Therefore, here V naught into V naught by RD, RD, capital RD, small RD, capital RD into minus GM into VI. Therefore, V naught by VI is equal to minus GM into small RD, capital RD by RD plus RD. That is minus GM small RD parallel with capital RD. This one is the gain of the amplifier, FET amplifier. Here minus sign indicates, 180 degrees phase shift between, 180 degrees phase shift between input and output signals. Input and output of the amplifier circuit. I will provide a PDF of this expression derivations. I also put in some section of that YouTube. Please see and clarify your doubts. Thank you.